What kind of farmer are you? I'm a land farmer, motherfucker!
I gotta start moisturizing my feet.
You gotta start moisturizing everything, especially your elbows.
I wanna be a cowboy, baby! Game
fight! Are you done?
Okay, sleepy.
I kinda liked eating stuff with red Kool-Aid back in the day.
Not fucking other sweet shit!
What if you
chocolate
don't?
Cake and then Kool-Aid afterwards,
what
man?
If, what if you don't sweeten your Kool-Aid that much?
Then you ain't making
you
it
ain't
right.
Making it right. Yeah.
What's up, guys? My name is Jason. We are Milltown Productions. This is
Jason.
This is
you're out of order.
I'm Brandon.
Out of order.
Now he says we're out of order.
Out.
But he's the one that didn't speak up.
Well, I pointed at you.
I know you did.
If I'd have pointed at you, and then he'd have been like, I'm Brandon, and you, I'm Jason. That'd have been a little...
Well, I guess...
Out of order!
I guess it was all Jace's fault this time.
Yes, it was.
He's a fucking idiot.
Damn.
Damn. That,
this bitch is pissing me off!
That evil laugh, he's like, he's an idiot. Yeah. What are we doing today?
Off my ears. Oh, I'll tell you exactly what we're doing.
You're right.
We're watching the 7th episode of Mike Flanagan's.
The 7th episode.
Haunting of his house.
Yes.
The haunting of his house.
The haunting of his house.
Now stay woke.
Or stay sleeping.
Ghosties creeping.
Well, why is your hat nodding? Why does that still look normal?
Oh, not on camera, it don't. This episode is called Eulogy. So we just had the viewing for Nell.
Yep.
Yeah. And that was honestly one of my favorite episodes so far.
It's mine too.
Two Storms was insane.
It was really good.
Not only the way they filmed it with all the one shots that were happening, but I just thought the acting was great. Me and you said that it reminded us of like a one act play.
Yes.
Loved that. I don't know. There's something about it. I was so into it the entire time. Then we saw the big, like, holy shit moment, really, which was Theo and Kevin.
Yes.
In the closet.
Oh, bro. I still think that was a one-time thing. Like, that's never happened before. I think that was just a spur of the moment, which is kind of weird. Like,
yeah, I don't think that's an excuse.
No, it's not an excuse. I'm not giving that. I'm not saying that as an excuse.
Yeah.
I'm just saying I don't think it's happened before, and I think that was like a one-time thing that they just, for some reason, decided to do. Or maybe they didn't decide to do it, just happened.
It's so like...
It's such a bad time.
Yeah, you're all fighting, and then you guys just disappear, and you're like, you know what? Let's fuck. You know, like, that doesn't compute, really.
No,
well,
it doesn't.
So, I think...
Yeah.
Theo kind of pushed herself onto him.
Yeah.
Because we've already seen that when she is filled with stress... That's what she does.
She fucks.
She pushes herself onto someone else to feel what they feel so she doesn't have to feel her own feelings.
That sounds kind of like rape.
She, you know what she does whenever she's stressed? She forces herself onto others.
Well,
do you feel?
Oh my God. So I think that's what she was in the middle of doing, not that.
Yeah.
I feel like he wasn't going to go all the way with it, or maybe he was, or maybe he was in the moments of like, oh shit, what is she doing? What is she doing? What are you doing?
Because what I noticed, he doesn't have his hands like on, like really
yeah.
her body.
He has them on her like arms, like almost looking like he's like pushing her off or something.
Yeah.
Or what if he was grabbing her arms and pulling her in and was like,
I mean, it could be a situation where he heard the door opening and was trying to get her off.
Yeah.
Not to get caught.
Yeah. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see.
Y'all ready to see?
I'm ready to see.
Good, because I'm ready to take this bitch off.
Hello, Hugh. Hello, Daddy. What does that look like? The uncle?
Sorry about that.
Oh, my God. His fucking eyes. Every time I see him, dude, they're so fucking
Did you say
blue.
You took cream of sugar? I gotta be honest, Hugh. It's a mess. It's a real mess. Your kids being pulled out of their bed in the middle of the night. And we're talking to them, of course. You're good at fixing things. I keep hearing this about you. Is that right? I'm not so sure anymore.
Maybe.
You leave a lawyer up. Suddenly, we can't fix this.
Well, you know, I mean, it's a rental. Not a lot of choices.
Okay, so he's, like obviously, he's obviously seeing someone. Let's just assume it's his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Is he crazy or is he actually seeing her?
Yeah, I think
he still talks. He's having like full-on conversations.
You're right. It's better.
See?
You're really a grandfather?
That's right.
How come we've never met you?
I don't care about their order. I'm talking about my order.
That's a little complicated, kid.
You've done business with actually, me. You knew this.
Met Jaden a while back.
I don't remember that.
Oh, well, you were really little.
Uh-oh.
Where have you been? You Hello. Missed breakfast.
Hello, Kevin.
Can we please talk?
Everett screwed us.
That's not the plywood one.
You yeah. Pop our lilies away. You need to pick up 4 bouquets.
Okay, I'll go in a minute, but can we just...
You're already on your way.
The flowers get gave
I have
away?
To shower and change my clothes. I mean, I didn't bring any of my... Okay. Mm-hmm.
I know you're upset with him because he took Steve's money, but he was only looking out for you and business.
Service starts at 10. It's 8:30. We're not open yet. If you want to lecture someone, lecture Theo.
Wonder where she gets that from.
Oh, I was about to say, we're going to see her.
Hey!
Space, but not like Cheryl. Since she was 3 years old, Shirley needed...
Shirley space.
Bear with her.
Wondering if it's one of those micro... Hey, bud.
Oh, it did break.
I'm wondering if it's one of those microbursts. You ever hear of those? Maybe, like, 2 miles wide. One of the most dangerous storms, but it hits a really small area.
Dad? This wall feels squishy.
What?
Feels squishy?
See?
Water damage. Yep.
Mark it.
There's a pipe there. I'm fixing all the pipes.
I can fix it.
Oh, he likes fixing things.
It's just, if your wall's already squishy and shit,
it's fucked.
Like,
he's Mr. Fix-It.
Gotta go,
Mr.
Gadget.
Fix-It.
What's that smell?
That is a smell of ruin.
Mold.
It's ruined.
Same thing.
Moisture.
That's really bad. Father Mucker.
Really, Dad?
What? There's water.
It's like a Polaroid.
Pull the whole wall down.
Maybe rats. Could be what happened to the pipes. When rats get thirsty enough, they'll shoot through just about anything.
Oh, it is a person.
Looks like a shadow.
Yeah.
Shirley doesn't want people in the house just yet, so I thought maybe I'd say hi.
Yeah, I bet Cheryl's in a mood. I fucked up last night, Daddy. I mean, I fucked up. Even by Crane standards. And if I make it through today alive, I'm gonna have to pack this all up and find a new place to live. And I don't think Shirley is ever gonna talk to me again.
And this doesn't have to do with Steve's money, does it?
Oof.
I mean, I can't think of a water source that explains it spreading like that down there.
We're gonna lose our shirts.
Magic.
Blueprint for this house are a disaster. And I've got 4 plans, none of them match. This house is schizophrenic. Some of them are just scribbles, and the work records are a mess. I'll combine these plans into one master blueprint, draw up something that represents the actual piping, and then we'll find out how fucked we really are.
We section off the infested walls, bring in fans to dry everything out, treat it with thymol, powerful stuff. Then we can see how bad off you are once you find the leaks.
I'll help.
It's a tough gig for a kid.
Oh, he's not a kid.
I didn't get a chance last night to tell you how proud I am of you. 90 days.
Thanks.
He doesn't want to make today about him. It's okay to just sit. Just be with him.
That's so sad. Hmm.
fucking kidding me?
What is she doing there?
Wait, who was it? I missed it. That's
what
Trish.
Are you doing here?
Figured she'd be here for you.
I saw the obit and I wanted to be here.
You thought you'd what, exactly?
Well, you didn't tell me that your sister died. I just wanted to support you, and if I'd known...
If I wanted you to know that, I would have told you that.
Oh, come on, Theo.
Look, it's okay. I'm sorry.
Just give her a hug, bro.
Fuck my day.
Okay or not.
Hello.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
I'm gonna add some strychnine to the shopping list.
Strychnine?
It's rat poison. See, Steve, your dad thinks that all this water is coming from that red room upstairs.
So, what's next? Finally.
What?
Be safe down here, okay? Good job, honey.
Hmm. What was he seeing?
I cannot say, and I will not say, that she is dead. She's just away. Think of her still as the same, I say. She's not dead. She's just away.
I will not go quietly into that good night.
I was born 90 seconds before Nell. And, I'd use that, too. You know, if we had a fight, or, if I wanted something, I'd say I was the oldest, so... She had to do what I said, and she let me get away with it. I mean, even though she knew it was bullshit. The last time I saw her, she was driving me to rehab. So she dropped me off. And she looked at me and she said, "You go in there and you bring my brother back. Bring my brother back."
Atta girl.
I was born 90 seconds before no. But she was always my big sister.
What's this?
Oh, it's the, I don't know exactly.
The missus do these?
Yeah.
Probably ain't my place. But maybe she could use a little time away from the house.
Time away from the house?
Yeah.
I think you might be right. It's probably not your place.
Oh.
You know, my mother worked in this house. She was kitchen staff. I was actually born here.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. When I was young, they moved us out to the cottage at the edge of the property. That's where I grew up. We ended up buying it from Miss Hill, and we're still there. But my mom, she never liked Hill House. She'd come home, sometimes after a long shift or a night shift. And she'd be scattered, you might say.
Scattered?
Talk to herself and the like. Towards the end, she'd wander into the woods at night barefoot.
Oh, shit.
And I swear I could hear her out there. Giggling like a schoolgirl in love. And she'd sleep out there sometimes too, so yeah. Scattered. So mom died, and I met Clara when she got hired on working for Ms. Hill. We even got married on the grounds. But Clara, she spent a lot of time in here. Clara got pregnant. Our first, a real blessing. But, Miss Hill made her keep on working, even with the baby coming.
Claire didn't complain. Because she's a strong woman. She's a towering woman. And so she did it. She didn't take any time. And so the day comes, the doc comes, and my little girl's stillborn.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
She never even got to have... Anyway, we offered it up, put it in God's hands, and but the nightmares she had. And Claire is a brave woman. And these nightmares, they had her down in a corner, shaking so bad I thought she'd seize up dead.
God, I'm sorry.
So one night, she's cleaning the master bedroom up there. This is before Hazel passed. She's cleaning Hazel's room. She hears a baby crying. Hears another room, too. And she goes looking and looking. And I mean, I thought she was losing her damn mind. But it rattled her so good. She ran home through the woods. No light. Scratched her face to ribbons on the branches. So I came back here with her one night and I'll be damned, but I heard it too, and I knew it. I don't know how. That was my first little girl's cry. That first cry, the one she never got to. We stopped coming here after dark. Yeah, just superstitious at first. But here's the thing, it worked. No more nightmares, no more crying, no one acting scattered. It's not my place. But if you find your missus is acting scattered, then yeah, maybe a little time away would do the trick. From the house, I mean.
I take your point.
Let's just take a moment to admire the actor.
Whole fucking soliloquy right there.
Yeah. Straight up.
Ride with us. I'll meet you there.
Cheryl. Coming with us?
I'll meet you there.
Need a ride?
Hey, Daddy, to the rescue.
Beautiful service. You know, I was talking to Theo this morning.
That's so.
And after listening to what you said today about Nellie and what your brother said.
Don't.
Your problems, we all do, but if there's one thing we can take away from today, it's that in the end, all you guys have is each other.
Did Theo tell you what she did?
No. But you know, we all fuck up and we can be upset with each other. But one day, we'll wake up and it'll be too late.
Stay the fuck out of my business. There it is. Stuck your hand.
Right in the fan.
Steve, can you unplug it over there? And hand me that hex wrench. It should be in that box.
Ooh, that's that shadow that you saw in the picture. But it looks like there's eyes and everything.
Jesus Christ! Fuck!
Dad?
Fuck, that got me big time.
I told you to unplug the...
I didn't!
It's okay.
I unplugged it.
It's okay, it was an accident. Fuck.
Fucking hell.
Oh, dang.
Oh.
Okay. All right, you fucker.
Oh, that's why he had that thing on his hand.
Yeah.
Break it down.
Fuck you!
Not with that hand. Yep. It's gonna start bleeding through. Yep. Yeah. Imagine like when he has to take that off, mm-hmm. And you have all that like, it's gonna be like attached to the skin and shit.
I'm so sorry.
Luke.
Yeah. I'm so sorry, Nell.
Oh, shit.
Throws him at the fucking ghost.
Don't.
Stay.
Luke.
Did you see her?
No.
It was mom. It was mom and Nellie. Yeah, stop it.
People see things, Luke. I know all about it. I write about it. Hell, I've seen things this week, but it's not real. It's not.
I wonder when the others are going to put two and two together, the bent-neck lady being Nell.
Yeah. Well, Luke and the dad know.
Yep. Well, Luke don't know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. When they sit there, Luke says, all this time, she's been, like, referring to
the bent-neck lady.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit.
Left?
She's got a fucking knife in her hand or some shit. Oh, hell no, bro.
Hell no. You get a brisk smack to the face. Get the fuck off me.
Liv. What the fuck?
I am. I'm sorry. I was having a horrible dream.
You think? You're holding a fucking screwdriver to my throat.
No, I wasn't.
We need to talk. We gotta do... I don't know what we have to do, but we have to do something. You're...
What?
You're fucking crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm what?
Not well.
What is this?
It's a master blueprint, you true.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
What's wrong?
I didn't know what this was. It's a footprint to our house.
Yep.
To our forever house. You drew it again and again.
I didn't.
You did.
I did. I guess I could see it. Janet's up for a visit.
Yes, please.
Just for a couple days or something.
That could be good.
I just think I've underestimated these migraines, you know. I'm not sleeping through the night at all.
I would not be in the same room as her right now.
It's constant dreams.
I have the nine. I know. Ready at all times.
You're just tired.
It just snuck up on me all of a sudden. But,
a horrible choice of words.
I'll sort it out.
She goes on a murdering spree and only ends up murdering herself. She didn't do a very good job.
Well, it didn't look like she hung herself, though.
No.
She got fucking splattered.
Yeah.
Maybe so, she took a shotgun to the face.
What if it's a situation where the dad's not saying anything because he had to be the one to put her down?
Right.
He
did good.
That's why he's got blood all over
Old
him.
Old Yeller style.
Yeah. Damn.
She tried to go all Crisp and Waugh, and he had to go Courtney Love.
I don't have to see them again for years. I don't want to.
I overheard you and Steve talking earlier at the grave. You know.
Well, it was embarrassing.
No. You know, I see your mother every day. I do. I have since she died.
Well, that's pretty nuts.
That's, for me, it's a coping mechanism. And you'd be surprised, a lot of widowers, widows, they do that. They recreate loved ones in their mind. And, you know, it's nothing to be embarrassed about. In fact, my therapist says that it's a perfectly normal.
Well, I'm happy for your death.
But.
Sydney's sister.
Doesn't mean it's always the case.
Cindy's sister, sorry.
Okay. Because people see things. And it's. I know it sounds nuts, but it's, but you don't have to feel crazy because sometimes...
Big boys know the difference between what's real and imaginary.
He said that to him.
Ooh. Isn't that right, Dad?
Professor X style. Oh, no. He's gonna take it and yank it. Oh, God. He's not load-bearing.
Yes!
Good Lord.
What the fuck?
I'm gonna keep the children upstairs.
Well, good news is Massachusetts doesn't require that you disclose you've had any death on the premises to any potential buyers.
You know, folks around town talk. They've always talked about this place.
Is it really haunted?
Is it?
What?
Haunted.
Oh. You know. Yeah. At least a few of my kids sure think so.
Does he have the bandage on his hand?
Yeah.
Listen, Steve,
What?
I'm sorry I didn't talk. And I'm sorry I didn't listen. And I'm sorry I wasn't there. And it's the regret of my life. I'm so, so sorry that I couldn't fix it.
What?
Come on.
You fly safe.
You too.
Shit.
You okay?
Yeah, I can't... find my credit card, and the caterer's gotta be paid. Did you tow my car?
Reception's over, Theodora. As far as you're concerned, we're closed.
Sorry. My car is gone.
What do you mean?
I mean my car is gone.
It's gone?
It was outside of my house like it always is, and now it's gone.
You probably parked it somewhere else.
I know where I parked my car.
My wallet's not in here.
Kevin,
it was in here.
You saw him.
Where the hell is it? Did Kevin take my goddamn wallet?
You saw him, but you didn't want to believe it.
Surely.
I'm sure it's around. Kevin's by the kitchen.
Guys?
Do you want my card? I can pay for the catering.
That's not the point. It was right here.
You knew it looked wrong. He looked wrong.
Has anybody seen Luke?
He was right there. He was looking at your... And then he wanted to have a smoke. He went outside about an hour ago.
Well, did he come back?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
Fucking hell! Can't even last one day?
An hour. Probably already has a needle in his arm.
We don't know that.
I'll check outside.
What's that?
Piss stain.
From the fucking coffin?
Is that dirt?
Yeah.
The house.
Oh, God. Oh, no, she's gonna kill someone.
It's okay. I can... I can fix it. Yeah.
You're not fixing this. I'm giving you every opportunity, and you...
Woo!
I don't know why you won't help me, Hugh.
I am helping you.
You keep saying that you didn't hurt her, but you get real upset if I say she killed herself.
I'm very tired.
And twice. Twice now, you say that the house killed her.
I know what I said.
So you're either in denial of your wife committing suicide, or you're in denial of something worse.
I didn't touch her.
And I don't know why you won't give me these 3 hours. You didn't call us for 3 hours because you were grieving.
That's right.
And first you say your wife went out of town.
I thought she did.
Mm-hmm. To be with her sister. But we talked to Janet and she never...
I know.
Your daughter Shirley says she woke you up because she was surprised to see Mom in the kitchen.
That's right.
And she says that you ran up the stairs to the red room.
And it was open.
So what did you see?
The mom had been
when
in
you
the,
got to the red room.
Nothing. That door's been locked since we moved in, so... It was nothing.
Nothing.
It's open.
Oh my fucking gosh. Sorry.
Our fucking gosh.
Well, episode 7, Eulogy. What'd you guys think?
Well, it's an interesting episode.
No. This shit's fucking pissing me off.
We have some answers, but not a lot.
Yeah.
Still a bunch of confusion.
Yeah.
Because
certain things are starting to come a little bit more into the light, but we're not seeing everything completely yet.
Yeah. Her dad, well, their dad is like an expert on like the supernatural shit.
Well,
at least that's what it looks like.
Well, he has
his widow.
Yeah. But is that what he said? A figment that he created in his mind to cope, or is that actually her?
I think it's actually her. I don't know.
Well, the way that she talks to him, like, when he's having the conversation with the kids, and she's like, don't do that.
Yeah.
And then, like, normally he listens to her, but he went against it this one time.
Yes, he did.
And it fucking bit him in the ass.
Yeah, backfired.
Safety.
I think Luke is going to the house.
To Hill House?
Yep. He stole Nell's car and Shirley's Theo's wallet. Car.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I meant. Stole Theo's car and Shirley's wallet, and I think...
Or her credit card.
Yeah.
Well, the whole wallet. She said, my wallet's not here.
Yeah, she said, did Kevin take my fucking wallet?
Yeah. Mm. So, yeah, I think he's going to the house.
But what does he need money for?
To get there. It's a drive.
I guess.
Well, it's a flight.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So, damn. So they better get there before he, like, goes in alone.
Does that mean that Nelly flew to the house and then rented a car? Like, flew to the airport and then rented a car to get there?
She might have.
Possibly.
Damn.
Who knows?
Who knows? I mean,
Nelly did have her own money. Luke's the only one that doesn't have his own money.
Yeah, but I mean, still, it's the fact that, like,
she would have flown into the airport, then rented a car at the airport, drove the rental to the house.
And then died.
Yeah.
Right. So she must have driven.
Yeah.
Have we figured out, I mean, it is Massachusetts, and they're in Boston right now, so it is doable by a drive.
Yeah. It'd be a long-ass fucking...
Yeah.
I would have tried to get in that red room, like, way before this.
More forcefully.
Mm-hmm. And so, if the Dudleys know that the house does this to people, he's like... Ever since then, we don't come here after dark.
We'll let you sleep here. But
yeah, so why does he let other people? I guess because they'll get fired if they start talking shit like that.
Talking shit. Yeah.
If they start talking like that, they'll probably get fired, and then like, then who will help the people who live there?
Yeah. You know?
Yeah.
But.
Yeah. But then you wonder, like, if they know that the dad is going to keep, like, control over the house, mm-hmm. and no one else is going to go in there, then why do they want to stay?
Yeah. And you know what? True. I'm also, like, with his description of their experience with the house, I figured it was going to be more.
Yeah.
Because, like, they seem like they know what's going on. They seem like they know a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, What was it? And then whenever she, when Nell, I mean Theo grabbed, when she grabbed Theo's arm and she goes, she's not mean, she's scared.
Mm-hmm.
So she's scared of the house. She's scared of what's in the house.
Mm-hmm.
But if all they've seen was, or heard was a baby crying.
But they knew that it was their baby.
Well, I know.
Well, then she said she kept having, like, crazy-ass nightmares. Yeah,
like the house was tormenting her with nightmares and shit.
Wow.
Nightmares that kept her in the corner screaming and crying.
Okay. Now, this doesn't explain why, even though they're not at the house anymore and they haven't been for years, the house still torments the fuck out of all of them.
I guess because they were the last ones there. And they technically, like, it's still owned by that family.
Yeah.
So maybe the house is like, I have dominion over you.
I guess so.
And I don't know. What the fuck was up with Nell and the mom at the grave?
That was weird as shit.
Don't stay, please stay. That shit.
So was Nell saying don't?
Like don't listen to mom?
Yeah.
Maybe. That's what it seemed like to me.
Mm-hmm. What's weird, too, is how the dad sees the mom perfectly fine.
Yeah.
But now the kids have seen the mom looking all sorts of fucked up.
Well, so did the dad when he was with
Theo right there at the end.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But what's weird also is that at Nell's wedding, Nell saw the mom standing behind Hugh, and she looked normal.
Yeah.
So, like, I don't know what's going on there.
Well, and then Luke also saw the mom looking completely normal whenever the bowler hat guy came real close and then turned around and it was the mom.
Yeah. So, I don't know what's going on with that dynamic. Like, is the mom fucked up, like, showing up fucked up to some and just not others, or...
I think... Like, I want it to be her actually talking to the father.
Yeah.
But, like, I think that when she shows up fine in his head, it is just in his head. Like, that is something that he come up with to cope. And I think whenever we see her fucked up, that's her actual spirit.
Yeah.
Because she died at Hill House, so I feel like her spirit would be tied to Hill House.
Maybe. It's a lot of what ifs.
Yeah.
It's hard. But also we see her spirit trying to talk Nell into, like, well, she's trying to talk her down. Like, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to die right now. But it's okay. It's for the greater good.
Yeah.
For the greater good.
It's the mom spirit that, like, convinces her to kill herself.
Yeah. Right.
Or she doesn't even kill herself. She's kind of pushed off the...
Yeah.
Right. She's, like, freaking out. And she's, like, tiptoeing on the edge. Yeah. And then all of a sudden, there's...
And the mom just kisses her on the forehead. And then she...
So the mother kills Nell.
Technically, yeah. Because she's the one that handed her the noose, too.
Yeah.
Making it look like a necklace.
Yep.
That's some fuck shit.
Bad mommy.
Mommy.
Bad.
Oh, shit.
Daddy. We saw that Cheryl has been gave Kevin the cold shoulder this entire episode.
Good, as she should.
Theo gave the cold shoulder to Trish. Should not have done that.
That was weird for Trish to do that.
That's definitely weird.
We've had sex one time, barely spoken to
it. Multiple times.
I did not mean to say that. We've had sex twice, barely. You don't probably don't even know my last name, but yes, show up to my sister's funeral, unannounced.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't know. Like, if she'd have showed up and been like, I just want to be here to support you, and like,
yeah,
I'd have been like, okay, like,
because that was one girl that I'd matched with on a dating app.
Yeah,
and then like I told her that I managed an AT&T store. And then, like, she was like, oh, that's right by my work. And then, like, the next day, she just walks into my work. And I was like, we've barely talked, and you're just showing up at my work?
Yeah, but to be fair, that's kind of how people met back before dating apps.
Well, doesn't matter.
We in the spa.
Okay, so what else happened?
Well,
Luke died.
Luke is probably going to die.
I really enjoyed that.
Hope they stop him in time.
Big ass monologue from Joe.
Yeah.
Yes.
I noticed one thing in the show is that every episode there's a monologue about death.
Yeah.
In every episode so far.
Yep.
There's been at least one little like section that's dedicated to someone talking about death.
Well, the episode is really, really good. Really good.
Yeah, it was really good. No complaints. Everything was good.
No complaint.
I was trying to grab under this.
Okay.
He's up. Oh, whoops.
My bad, bro.
I was so confused.
I was trying to just get my hand under this part right
here. It was really good. A lot of really cool stuff. There's things that were kind of sort of answered, but things that were kind of not answered. We got a backstory to the guy who floats with the cane in the bolo hat.
He fucking bricked himself in and then decided against it too late.
Yeah, he had second thoughts. Does anyone have anything else to say about the show?
It was good. See you guys.
Can't wait for the next episode.
Yeah.
Come and watch it with us.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.